My heart is really heavy right now. There has been public outcries and protests in my city, in my county, and I can't continue to pretend that the lives that we are so casual about in this continual epidemic is normal. It's not a normal day anymore for me. And what I realize as a parent of three, the hardest thing that one could ever receive is a call that your young one will not ever return back. And in this past week, we've celebrated Juneteenth, which was the Freedom Day and the recognition of independence of former enslaved people in this country. And on that same day, we lost a young, talented 17-year-old African-American male, Antoine Rose. And a day later, we lost an inspiring, up-and-coming African-American artist to street violence named Jimmy Walpole. Now, these are just two examples of stuff that happens all over this Commonwealth, all over in every city and borough, and all over this country. And both of them, I call them two tips of a very dangerous spear, and that is black-on-black crime and violence and black-on-blue crime and violence. And both of them need to be addressed and stopped because there are far too many wasted lives that are never reaching their full potential because of these things. And the fact of the matter is, Mr. Speaker, I think what we do here in this hall, in this Capitol, matters tremendously what happens on the ground with these things stopping. And it's not just a financial thing. It's a change in culture. It's a value set that lives matter no matter who they are and what race they come from or what community they come from. And we cannot casually keep closing our eyes and ears to the fact there is a group of people whose lives seemingly don't matter. And when I look at my 12-year-old, I look at my 6-year-old, my 3-year-old, I believe their lives is just as important as any other life. But every time they leave my house, I worry about if they're gonna lose their life. Lose their life by somebody who looks like them or somebody who's afraid of what they think they are or will be. And so as we make these final decisions today, what I wanna also encourage us to do is to look around our communities, question the fact that this system that we currently have isn't working for all of our citizens, that something really needs to change. The conversation itself needs to change. This is about life and death for a group of people who, for some reason, are dying and perishing at far too great a number than what they should be. And so I want to just, before we begin our work today, I had to get that off my chest because I'm at a point now, I'm a loss for words and actions, and I'm trying to keep myself together. Because when I leave up out of this building, I could be the next victim. And all I'm trying to challenge us to do is when we have these conversations, know that there is a problem in our Commonwealth, in our cities, in our boroughs, in our municipalities, and we can't be silent about it anymore.